two Corvairs, 69 and a 65. I didn't know they made them in 69. Must be the last year. Hemi Dodge 66 and a four door. Another Hemi Dodge Coronet. Challenger 70 Dodge with a Hemi. It's a nice old Chrysler Custom Imperial. Chrysler Convertible 54 MG Convertible. It's a Volkswagen chassis, engine, transmission, four bolts, and you can take that engine out, undo some wires. Volkswagen engine. Here's my favorite engine, Chevy V8 265. Can't tell if it has body numbers or engine. Yeah, it has engine numbers. There's a 55 Chevy. All the Delray has a little bit different interior. More vinyl, less cloth. I like these old coupes, 41 Chevys. They made them the same after the war. 46, 47, almost identical. Buick. One of the first ever cars, Orient buckboard, never heard of it. Another Buick, 1910, another 1910 Buick. A Metz. Studebaker. I think it's the only one in here. 41 Studebaker.
Restored just immaculately. And it
Studebaker champion.
It has a gear drive, which is very unusual.
Another Studebaker. Studebaker truck.
They made bikes before they made cars. Those pedals don't look too comfortable, do they? And of course, we have display cases with lots of different models that I've acquired over the years. You know, people send me stuff. I see something that I like, I might buy it, or a model of a car that I might have owned at one time or another. Lots of antique cars, models of them, and they're quite interesting. Now, Franklin Mint has done a lot of very intricate models, which I have a lot of those. They do real nice work. You can see some of them right there in the cases. Expensive, some of these cars, you know, $200-$300 they were at one time. Of course, in the parlor is a really nice place for the ladies to sit down and enjoy themselves, because, you know, sometimes they don't want to walk around and look at the cars for hours on end with the men, but they can sit in here and look at things from the past, read magazines that were, you know, back in the days when grandma was a young woman. They can see different things that they women had to use to keep house, old sewing machines, old irons, all types of stuff that my wife and I have gathered over the years to show what it was like back in the old days. It wasn't always so easy for the women to keep house. Not quite as easy as it is today. There's an old video.
So Army stuff, ordnance, or whatever they call it, grenades, rockets. That's because Dom was in the Navy. Ford Roadster, 35 Ford Roadster, 34 Cabaret. Your window coupe. Deluxe three window coupe, because you got a rumble seat. '29 Ford Model A Tudor Roadster pickup. Big gas pump. And soapbox racers up on the on top there. One-arm bandits. Compressor brake. Hudson Hornet.
A flathead.
Another Ford flathead. Cutaway. Another Ford flathead. V12. of flatheads. Lots of flatheads. It's a 44, this is a 41 Mercury. This one is another Lincoln 12 cylinder. Flatheads, flatheads. Three Mercury. Two Corvair engine. Jukebox. Crosley, two Crosleys, Roadster and a station wagon, and another Hemi. Chrysler, sorry. Apologize. My apologies for calling a Chrysler a Cadillac. Plymouth. Studebaker. There is another Studebaker. I like that front. The bullet. Commander Starlight. Wolfman Jack back there, next to Marilyn Monroe. This guy delivered sand, coal, and gravel. 47 Studebaker dump truck. Fort Lauderdale.
Convertible, very, very unusual. 39 Ford Cabriolet. They has roll-up windows, and that's what makes a difference. If it has curtains, it's called a Roadster. If it has roll-up windows, it's called a Cabriolet. The last Roadster was in 1937 for Ford. There's a restored 39 Ford Coupe alongside an original 39 Ford Coupe. This was the original car from Indianapolis. That 40 Mercury four-door, that's the last year that Ford made the four-door convertible. And it's a very rare.
There's a three-window, five-window coupe. Missing its fenders.
And so people didn't pay that kind of money back in the days of the Depression. But a few rich people are, so consequently there are
36 Ford Coupe. '37 Ford half ton pickup. I like that. It's a nice truck. Here's a 37 Ford Roadster. '37 Ford 5-window. '39 Ford Deluxe. Coupe Deluxe. '39 Ford Deluxe Coupe. What's the difference between Coupe Deluxe and Deluxe Coupe? Okay, we're almost done. We're just going to walk down the middle. Stream back there. We got a motorcycle here. 82 Suzuki three-wheeler. I don't think that would be a factory built. And here is a lawnmower. Hemi power, no. Big block Chevy lawnmower. And a 57 Thunderbird with porthole windows. '63 Ford Fairlane race car. I think that's a Willys, 41 Willys pickup truck. In orange. Another Dodge Coronet. Centerline wheels. These are like the wheels on my truck. '31 Chevy.
Chrome on some of the places. That's a convertible steering wheel there. The four spoke here, really hard to find. And the dash is
40 Willys.
Liked all the instrumentation. But we got the leather interior. And the
okay, one more walk around.
That kind of dresses up the interior.
We're out of here.
The hubcaps of the automobile Starfire.
Just about to wrap this video up.
And fender skirts. Those are stock Ford three ribs. My wife and I drove this car a lot. Now this is a car that we always wanted when we were young, a 1954 Crestliner, but they were about $500 or $600 more. They were beautiful though, with all the special trim and hubcaps and steering wheels, and they also put that four-spoke steering wheel in the Crestliner. Now, we never owned one until we had the museum because they were too expensive. And of course, they're very expensive now. A good Crestliner today is worth $25,000 or $30,000. Here's a 53 Chrysler Hemi that they sent out for the
this gauge is. I need to find a vacuum gauge for my truck.
I got a big one, but way too big. How did I do? I'm gonna wrap this video up.